President Trump has been repeating this claim about face mask research that is false and misleading.
You have a report coming out 2 days ago that 85% of the people wearing masks.
I looked at that report. It's not about mask wearing. It was neutral
on the question of masks. We're on the same side.
He uses that claim as a go-to talking point, which he repeated again.
I'm good with masks. I'm okay with masks. I tell people wear masks. But just the other day, they came out with a statement that 85% of the people that wear masks catch it. So you know,
they didn't say that. I know that study.
That's what I heard, and that's what I saw.
So Trump claims that 85% of people who wear face masks catch the coronavirus. This is the study that Trump referred to, Fisher et al., who concluded on what their data indicate, which is that congregating in public places where you and the people around you take masks off, such as restaurants, increases your risk of COVID-19. So the study Trump cited actually provides evidence that face masks do work. What the researchers did was compare 154 subjects who had tested positive for the virus that causes COVID-19 to 160 subjects who had tested negative at the same healthcare facilities. The positive subjects were the cases, and the negative subjects formed the control group. Their goal was to see how community and close contact exposures may differ between the groups. While the study was not designed to test the efficacy of face masks, the authors collected data that showed that 85% of the cases reported that they always or often wore a face mask, versus 89% of the controls. While mask use was less among the cases, the difference was not statistically significant. If we want to extrapolate these data to the general public, as Trump and others have, what they actually suggest is that if you're not wearing a face mask, it's possible that around 80% of the people around you are. And the masks on those people protect you from their droplets. Generally speaking, you are more protected by the masks around you than the mask that's on you. So the better metric of face mask efficacy isn't whether a subject wore a mask, but whether the people around the subject wore masks. And it's by that better metric that this study provides evidence that face masks work. The primary finding of this study is illustrated in this forest plot, which shows that the only statistically significant difference between the COVID cases and the control group was in going to restaurants. So those who tested positive were significantly more likely to have gone to a restaurant. The only other statistically significant difference was that those who tested positive and who had no close contact who had COVID-19 were more likely to have gone to a bar or coffee shop than those who tested negative. We know these results are statistically significant because the confidence intervals for only these three results are to the right of this dashed line. In contrast, there was no statistically significant difference between the groups with respect to other community exposures, such as shopping, being in an office setting, going to the salon, going to a gym, public transportation, or religious gatherings. And remember that over 80% of the subjects, whether they tested negative or positive, always or often wore a mask. So why would going to restaurants, bars, and coffee shops be the only significant difference between those testing positive and those testing negative? The authors propose an answer to that question in stating, quote, "Masks cannot be effectively worn while eating and drinking, whereas shopping and numerous other indoor activities do not preclude mask use." So the authors concluded that those who tested positive were approximately twice as likely to report having dined at a restaurant than those who tested negative, and that efforts to reduce possible exposures where mask use and social distancing are difficult to maintain, such as when eating and drinking, should be considered to protect customers, employees, and communities. Further supporting this conclusion is that when subjects in both groups were asked about the mask-wearing habits of other people in the restaurants and bars they customed, those who tested negative, who are the control participants, more often reported that restaurant patrons around them were more compliant with face mask wearing or social distancing. And this difference was statistically significant for patrons of both restaurants and bars. So not only did the results of this study indicate that people are at greater risk when they congregate in places where they remove their masks, but that people who congregated in such places were at even greater risk when more people around them showed disregard for face mask wearing and/or social distancing, which is exactly what we would expect if taking off your face mask and being around lots of other people who are taking off their face masks increases your risk of catching the coronavirus. So now let's loop back and listen to President Trump's claim again.
Just the other day, they came out with a statement that 85% of the people that wear masks catch it.
And that, of course, is not what the study found, nor what any of the authors stated. We are not at liberty to just make up the results of studies. What the study found was that there was no statistical difference in mask use between 154 subjects who tested positive for COVID and 160 who tested negative. But there was a statistically significant difference, and only such a difference, in the rates that subjects went to eating and drinking establishments. Those who tested positive were more likely to have gone to a restaurant, and in the subset of subjects who had no close contact infected with COVID-19, those who tested positive were more likely to have gone to a bar or coffee shop. What's unique about restaurants, bars, and coffee shops, unlike the other social interactions they examined, is that they are places where you and the people around you take off their masks in order to eat and drink. So what looks to me like the best logical interpretation of this study is that you can wear your mask practically always or often, but if you go to a restaurant and take your mask off to eat and drink, you throw all your prior mask wearing out the window and significantly increase your risk of catching the coronavirus, especially if you go to a restaurant or bar where there is a higher disregard for the use of masks and/or social distancing. In the big picture, while the results of this study are interesting, highlighting the potential risks of catching the coronavirus at restaurants, it's a small study, and it's just one study. The only reason it's circulating through the news is that Trump and other anti-mask activists happened to notice the data in one table in the study and have blown it out of proportion and badly misrepresented it to advance their agenda of persuading people that they don't need to wear a face mask. The moral equivalent of trying to persuade people not to wear seat belts or not to wear bicycle helmets. To get answers to questions on the efficacy of face masks, we need to consult studies designed to answer those questions. And I review numerous such studies in my previous video here.